Hi, everyone. My name is Whitney Staub-Jurgens, and I am the Vice President of Clinical Operations for Healthcare Corporation of America's Care Transformation Innovation Team. So excited today to share with you our transformative solution to healthcare scheduling and staffing. It's been a fantastic journey with Palantir, and we've been on this adventure for a little over a year. So I'm really excited to give you some insights into how we've been successful and how we believe we can be even more successful in the future. So what is the problem that we set out to solve for? This is really all about making sure that we have the right people in the right place at the right time to deliver care to our patients. And for us, we realized that this was really about addressing a large degree of variation in our patient volume and complexity. And that variation occurs from schedule to schedule, from week to week, from day to day, from hour to hour. And for us, this is really all about how do we optimize schedules? And when you optimize a schedule for a nursing unit, there's trade-offs that you need to make. And part of the problem to solve for today is that you can't see those trade-offs very well, and you can't see the process level data that you need to be able to see. So this, again, for us, is really about making sure that we're matching our staff skills, competencies, and proficiencies with the patient work intensity needs that we have at any given time. So what does current state look like? This is one of my absolute favorite graphics to share with others in the industry who are trying to understand this problem to solve for. This is a snapshot, if you will, of our current state, what we would call our clinical labor management process. Everything in dark right now is manual, meaning that it lives within a nurse leader's head, or it's on a paper, or somewhere where there's no data trail. So if you start at the top, those unit operating norms are really difficult for healthcare right now. And these are kind of unit nuances to, you know, what are some of those specific and individualized scheduling and staffing practices, or knowledge that's native living in the nurse leader's heads, or some of those individual staff preferences. And because that's hard to see right now, when that funnels through, at least in HCA's case, 3,000 individual nurse leaders and 3,000 individual units, we get a lot of variable outcomes. So for us right now, and for a lot of healthcare organizations, it's very difficult to understand why we're getting the outcomes that we're getting, knowing that we can't see into those processes. In partnership with Palantir, we're very proud. We've embarked on a digital transformation for how we allocate care team members. So now if you think about that current state where everything is dark, we can't see it, it's process data that's hidden to us. We're now moving into digital processes that have a data trail. So you can see how the picture transforms, and we're now able to get insight into those critical processes that we couldn't see yesterday. A couple new inputs in our new processes. We're very proud to bring forward a talent profile. This is all about capturing the unique skills, talents, and proficiencies of our direct caregivers. For us, proficiency has been a big distinguisher in how we build a schedule, and that is how autonomous can the registered nurse be in any given environment? And we measure that according to whether they're beginner, whether they consider themselves proficient, or whether they're expert. They self-rate that, that's validated by their unit leader. That's a critical input for us when we go to automate and build a schedule. Our other new input is what we're calling staff schedule preferences. This is similar to current state self-scheduling. However, we've introduced the concept of a Likert scale for the staff, and they now tell us whether they prefer to work, whether they don't prefer to work, or whether it's neutral. Those options are really critical inputs because they give the unit leader flexibility and the ability to turn dials based on what the unit needs. Other new inputs include better volume predictions, better forecasting, and then a roles engine that constructs the schedule on behalf of the nurse leader. So there's three important interventions at play, or that will be at play, and what we're referring to as Timpani, which is our digital scheduling and staffing transformation solution. The first is the automated schedule. The second is the automated staffing intelligence. And the third, which is not built in the tool yet, but we're working directly with Palantir to prototype and test this workflow as a day of assignment workflow. All three of those processes working together in a scheduling and staffing ecosystem is what is giving us critical insights into the processes that we can manage in order to make sure that we get optimal outcomes, both for our care team members and our staff. So what does this mean for our staff, our nurse leaders, and our executives? I'm a registered nurse by background, so something that's very important to me and that I'm passionate about is that this is a meaningful intervention for our staff, and they're able to get balanced, equitable, and transparent schedules. Our nurse leaders make every effort to do that today, but they're humans, and at the end of the day, they simply can't manage the amount of inputs that they need to be able to manage to be successful in the future. For our nurse leaders, this is time savings. I've been a director at one of our hospitals, and I've built these schedules manually for years, and it truly takes anywhere from 12 to 20 hours a month for a nurse leader to build these schedules. So the prospect of having this automated, digitalized, and being able to give that time back to those nurse leaders is very, very important. And finally, for our executives, the process level insights that we're now able to get into labor, productivity, and other staffing information is critical for us to run our business. As I said, we can't see that process level data today, so it's very important for us to be able to see that and manage to an outcome. I mentioned that we've been on this journey for close to 6 months now, we've actually been in a production environment, and I would highlight that this is one of the key partnership lessons learned on behalf of HCA and Palantir working together, is that ability to get into the production environment live and in action and bring this work to life. So we've learned important operations lessons out of that are helping us understand change management, the education, and the at-scale implementation efforts that we need to take to go further to scale at HCA, and of course, critical enablement lessons in both our alpha and our beta pilots. So what were some of our organizational impacts? I'm proud to say we're one of the health systems that now have key and critical insights into how we do this at scale successfully, not just from a technology perspective, but from a people and a process perspective. So some of what I can offer and some of those insights are what we're referring to as our impacts and transition support. The first is that the staff will feel that the schedule preferences are very different, and we've found several key narratives to helping them understand the benefit of this from them. The data is very powerful. We've found that in working in partnership with Palantir, we've been able to produce schedules where the solver is preserving over 98% of the staff's preferences, which we're really proud of, and that's across all 9 facilities. This effort is going to help us standardize our scheduling and staffing operating procedures. This is very difficult today, again, because of the variation and the lack of standardization. The manual process is filtered through our 3,000 nurse leaders. And it's simply that they can't see what they need to see in order to make good and timely decisions. Our schedule algorithm and our business rules for our automated scheduling solution is going to help us to prioritize needs of our PRN nurses or ad-lib nurses in a little bit of a different way. But this is really going to help us preserve the full-time and part-time staff preferences in a way that we've not been able to before. And then I also want to call out our shift from paper to real-time digital systems. As I said, I'm a registered nurse by background, and I'm very familiar with paper. I practiced on paper for a number of years, and this is a difficult change for a lot of our nurse leaders when you remove the paper from their workflow. And you know, it's not a great system, and it's very manual, but it's their system, and they know it very well. So part of our role in the Care Transformation Innovation Team is to really start to understand those change management and change leadership insights that we can leverage to help the nurse leaders through that change. I wanted to show you a little bit of the data that we're seeing and just the power of the tool and the power of the partnership with Palantir. On the top graphic, Hospital A, those blue shifts are the number of shifts allocated to that unit. So that's based on their forecast and their predicted productivity needs. Where you see those orange bars, that's the manual edits that those nurse leaders at Hospital A are making. When I look at Hospital B, comparative to their allocated shifts, there's far fewer manual edits. And in conversations with these hospitals, it was very clear that there was different buy-in, a little bit of a different narrative and different leadership tactics that were employed at Hospital B versus Hospital A. But again, in thinking of lessons learned going to scale, key leadership and change management insights from Hospital B, as well as helping us understand what are some of those practices driving those manual edits at Hospital A that we might not necessarily endorse at this point, and then be able to help those nurse leaders think about those managing those processes differently. This next data set tells you a little bit about how the solver is performing with respect to managing staff preferences. On the top is the machine generated without any human intervention. So this is before a human touches the schedule. The green is the shifts that were allocated to nurses based on their preferences. Blue is neutral, and red is when a nurse said, I prefer not to work that day, but because of the forecasted demand, they may have been placed on that day. And that does happen and should happen in any given unit. The bottom data set is machine generated. Now this is with human edits. So this is after our nurse leaders edit the schedule. One of the very difficult things about scheduling today is that because it's so manual, it's very difficult for the human in the loop to understand the exponential impacts of the decisions that they're making. But we can see it in this data set that the more times that we interact with that schedule and make those manual moves, we're actually making those preferences worse for the nurse. And many of our nurses would tell us that today, that the more that we manipulate that schedule, the less often they get their preferences. And we saw that hypothesis play out in our data set. So where do we go from now? As I said, we've been able to scale this to our acute inpatient units at 9 facilities, and we're looking ahead to the future. We'll be at 180 plus hospitals within the next several years, and that's 90,000 nurses strong at HCA. So very excited to bring them the potential to have their preferences first and foremost prioritized, and also make sure that we're balancing their preferences with the needs of the unit. And then if I think very big picture, just to close us out, what is this full scheduling and clinical labor management journey going to look like for us? I spoke about our new productivity forecasting and how we're using that talent profile and schedule preferences to bring automation to scheduling and staffing. What I've not talked about yet that we're particularly excited about for the day, what we call day of, is leveraging a third solver. And what we're referring to is our work intensity calculation, which is going to help us quantify how work intensive or difficult a patient assignment is. And with the information in the talent profile, we'll be able to match the unique talent, skills, and abilities of each nurse with the work intensity of the patients in our units. And of course, that information all aggregates together in the executive dashboard. New data, new insights, again, speaking to the power of the HCA and Palantir partnership that we'll be able to bring to our facility and our corporate leaders.